falls under the umbrella of the town. So if there's a problem within the town between him and employees, other council members, etc., instead of that being covered by our insurance pool and something that we would perhaps have to absorb, it would depend on a case-by-case basis in terms of the legal costs. So their recommendation to me when this first started was document everything. And that's why this notebook exists. And they said, what prompted it, just for a little story, is when we had the dumpster diving and I reacted to it, and then I thought, okay, maybe I'm overreacting here. I called the risk pool after he got them reacting. He said, oh no, you have to respond to this because there's liability issues in the midst of it. And to address the hostile work environment, I did have a meeting with all the employees to try and put some facts out about what has transpired. I am interviewing each one of them individually, and the chief is interviewing each of his officers individually to try and, you know, assuage some fears, discuss any concerns they have, just try and communicate the fact that this isn't happening in a vacuum. We're working on the situation. And I told them as things progress, we will have another meeting so that they don't feel like they're out in the wilderness, so to speak, that we still do have a town government that cares and a town administration that cares about how they are doing.
I'll try to make it brief, but I could probably talk for the next hour. I'll try not to. I know we got council tonight, too. Let me say that, you know, while you're on this topic, creating a hostile work environment, certainly I don't think that there's any two individuals that have been affected more than this, than myself and the town manager. Although there are other employees, I'm sure, that have been affected just as much. The whole event of this thing since the beginning, since he's been elected as mayor, and the allegations and the accusations and the charges, the complaints that I've sustained, have worn deeply on me to the effect that I feel like I've neglected the police department. When I neglect the police department, I neglect the public. It went beyond creating a hostile work environment for myself. Every officer that we have that served this town is affected by this. Besides the allegations of myself of kidnapping, assault, misappropriation of grant funds, stealing vacation time, and numerous other acts. Mr. Foster's allegations in that have a direct correlation with other people within the community that certainly have a dislike for the police department and the town as a whole in itself. I certainly wish Mr. Foster was here. I hope he would be here. I don't like making my own comments or allegations against anybody without them being able to defend themselves. But I know for a fact Mr. Foster has had a direct connection to a person here by the name of Jennifer Harris, who operates a blog website. Some of you read it, some of you don't, some of you won't. I'm glad that most of you don't choose to read it. I have to make it a point to read not only the Mineshaft, but the other Arizona blog spot, as well as another Quartzsite News Online online publication, in order to keep informed with what's going to happen the next day, basically. But just in recent, not only myself, but every member of my department, you know, on these sites and that, have been basically charged with everything imaginable. And let me make it clear that, you know, I do not believe that Mr. Foster is a direct publisher of this Arizona blogspot that Ms. Harris operates, but I can tell you just in recent days from there, we've again been accused of everything and anything imaginable just about it. It is, but the reason I bring these in, because they are all intertwined, they are connected. The hostile work environment goes beyond myself, but it reaches out to every member of the police department. They're looking over their shoulders every time they go to a call, wondering who's videotaping them, wondering who's recording them in some sense, who's going to make the next false allegation. And it's, you know, our job is dangerous enough. It's even more dangerous, though, when we have to worry about these kind of things as we do our job. The Quartzsite Police Department is not corrupt. I am not corrupt. The allegations that Mr. Foster has made against me, I've been exonerated. I will stand before you or any member of the public, be it whether you like the police department or dislike the police department. I get up every morning, I look at myself in the mirror, and I'm okay with what I see. But I can tell you that this is wearing on me. And it wears on the department. And when it wears on us as public servants, it wears on the community. And, you know, I'm very pleased with the last couple council meetings. You know, I've been here now just very short of 5 years. I've been to probably 95-98% of council meetings. Very few of them I have ever missed. I came here 5 years ago. I came to the council meetings to be a member of the public, to represent the police department, to be a friend, to answer questions, to whatever. I come to the council meetings now to keep the peace. And I shouldn't have to do that. The disruptions that have occurred over the past several months are disheartening, are embarrassing. And I praise the members of this committee for taking it upon themselves to address these issues. Mr. Foster was elected as mayor. I respect him as mayor. I told him that if he had any questions with the police department, he can come in my office. He's never chosen to do that. Most of you other council people certainly have done that. If you don't see me down here, you come to my office if you have a question. I've made that offer personally to Mr. Foster. He has not yet made any effort to do that. I hope the result of this is that it all stops. I hope that the false allegations stop. I hope that he decides to take a different approach as a mayor and supports this town instead of degrading it on a daily basis. I hope that the public understands that there's more to the story and that there's more than one side to it. Whatever actions you take, if you take any action, I'm sure that they will be appropriate. And I hope that the town heals from this. And Quartzsite is a wonderful community. It's a wonderful place for people to visit. It's a wonderful place for people to live. And I do believe that the community will heal from this. It certainly is hard to endure for everybody. I just want to make those expressions to you as to what I hope becomes of this. And whatever actions are taken, and Mr. Foster is not here, but I hope that he looks at these things in a positive way, and that he chooses to be the mayor of Quartzsite, that he starts acting like one and representing the town in a positive fashion.
We didn't want to do this. We wanted to meet with him and solve the problems, and he was elected by the town to be mayor, and we wanted him to work with us. he doesn't want to. We've asked him to give us the letters that he sent out, a copy, so we could have them in our, in the file here in town, in our archive. We asked him, you know, to meet with us.
Twice.
He wouldn't do it. So he wanted it public, because it didn't have to be public. Because we wanted him, wanted to find out, does he need more education? Did he need to sit down with some of us and hash out some stuff? Because knowledge is the best healer. But he decided he didn't want to do that. He wants to be the mayor and not the council. And we really do need to have a council, including the mayor, that works together. Like I said, we did not want to do this. We want to do the work of the town. This is, we're up here to do the business, not to do this. And that's all I have to say.
Pam, where are we at now? I mean, do we basically adjourn this and then digest a little bit and then we come back to figure out what actions possibly to recommend to the council, or?
That certainly is an option. It's up to the committee to decide what you want to do at this point in time. If there is further information that you need, if you have further questions, you can look into those things. You can go ahead today and make determinations as to what the committee wants to recommend. Or you can adjourn and set and do that at a later meeting.
Yeah, I've got some things that I need to digest, some things that I didn't know about before coming into this meeting that I need to mull over.
Okay. I want to thank everybody for coming, and we'll adjourn, and we will set up another meeting to let everybody know what we're going to be doing.
Thank you.
Thank you all for coming.